Unless you work in the stock market, you're probably not aware of a series of charts that allow you to plot stock prices. Now, the whole point of this, though, is that these particular charts do something quite unique. So just to show you first how it works, I've got some data here, dates, and the opening price of a share, the high for the day, the low, and the close. Now, if we highlight that, we go to insert, and you'll see over here I've got something called stock charts, and the one we're looking for here is called open high low close. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just click on this, and you'll see it creates this type of chart. Now, just to make it a bit more presentable, you'll see Excel is guessing that you wanted to see weekends, and that's not what we want. So I'm just going to quickly change this so we can see it next to each other. So what this stock chart does is it shows you the opening, the high, the low, the close. But what's impressive is that the colors change depending on whether it was up or down for the day. So for example, on day one it opened at 6,800 and closed at 7,000. So what it does is the bottom is the opening, the top is the closing, and white indicates it went upwards. You'll see on the last day it's colored black. That's because it opened at 6,975 and closed at 6,370. And then you've got lines that come out of it, and that's the high for the day and the low for the day. But the important thing here is that these colors change on their own and they can be customized. So if I hover over there and I right click, you'll see I've got an option to format the up bars. So maybe the up bar should turn green, for example. And then I'll just go to one of these, can right click, just got to find the down bar option there, format down bars. And I'll use this way now and we'll make it perhaps red. So the benefit of this chart is you can make it change colors on its own without you having to manually change the color when it goes up or down. So with that in mind, let's see how we can trick Excel into using this chart to do a waterfall chart. So here we've set it up in a very similar way. So notice I've got a column for open, high, low, and close. So even though I don't need high and low, for the purposes of this chart, I need to put them in. Then I've got something called budgeted profit. You'll see I've typed in a zero here. So it starts at zero and it closes at a number, that's 100. And then in order to make it work, the open of the next item is the close of the previous item. And then these just are numbers that we've captured. So what we're trying to say is we budgeted a profit of 100, we ended up on 110, and the reason is, and there's a couple of reasons. So we can highlight this, I'm going to say insert. We must go to this chart here, which is an open, high, low, close. When I click on it, now when you first look at it, you'll see it doesn't quite look right. So just a trick with charts, before you go and try and change data, just go up to design and there's a switch row and column. When I click on it, you'll see immediately that looks a bit better. So what we've got here is the budgeted profit in an up color goes up to 100, and then because of the way we set it up, retrenchments starts there and goes down. So it shows us that it was down because of that. It starts again at that same point and goes down because of an electricity hike. And then we had a selling price increase, so it starts here and goes up. And the benefit of this is we can now easily right click, and let's make it a nice bright green. And over here, we can right click and maybe make that red. And fairly quickly, we can create a waterfall chart. And just to show you, let's say the selling price increase was actually a bit more, so it got us to maybe 150. You'll see it automatically does it. And maybe retrenchments actually didn't bring us down, it saved us money. So let's make that 110. So you'll see immediately, because it went up, it changes color. So this is one way to trick Excel to generate a waterfall chart.